Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the sum of digits of a number in Python. So let's get started. So first we'll be inputting the number from the user, alright? So let n be my number equal to int of input, enter a number, that's it. And next I will explain you how we are going to separate each digit from the number and finding the sum. So for this, we will be using a while loop to perform this operation. So here we will be using a while loop to iterate through each and every individual digit, and after that we will be finding the sum of the entire digit. So here we will be having three important steps. The first one is going to be extracting the last digit from the number. Okay. So we will be doing this with the help of modulus of 10. We will just do modulus of 10 to the number. So for example, you have a number 123. And we need to extract the last digit, we will just do 123 mod 10, right? So this will give the remainder as 3. So modular operator just gives us the remainder of a number. So this is the first step that we will be doing. And the second step is going to be, we will be adding this remainder, okay? This remainder that we got, so we will have a variable as rem, just consider it as rem, and we will be adding this remainder to our sum variable. We'll have a sum variable and CAP, okay? And we'll just add this particular remainder to the sum variable, and this sum variable initial value will be 0, okay? So that to avoid any junk values. So this process will be continued after that. And the third most important step is going to be removing the last digit of the number, last digit, okay? So we will do this with the help of n equal to n double slash 10. That is, we will find the quotient. So let's suppose say that I am having the number as 123. So to remove the last digit, 123 double slash 10 will give me 12. It's just a quotient. And the reason why I'm using double slash is because if I use single slash, I'll be getting a decimal or a float number. And by using double slash, I'll be getting a whole number. That's the reason. And after removing the last digit, I'll be storing this number with n itself. So after this iteration, my number will be equal to 12. So this process will be continuously repeated until my number becomes 0. So our while loop condition will be if number greater than 0. If our number becomes 0, we will just stop this. And at the end, our number will be 0. Just imagine doing this step again. So 12 double slash 10, it will be equal to 1, and 1 double slash 10 will be equal to 0. So at the end, anyways, our number is going to 0. So these are the three steps. So enough of commenting things. Let's just now go and code. All right. So as I told you, the first condition is going to be while loop, and the number is going to be greater than 0. And next one is going to be extracting the last digit. So it's going to be remainder equal to number modulus of 10. And next line, we will be adding it to our sum variable. So it's going to be sum equal to, I'll just have it as sum variable or something. Yeah, that's better. Sum variable. Sum equal to sum variable plus remainder. And as I told you, we will be initializing this particular variable to 0. Okay, so I'll just have here equal to 0. And you can just name it anything. You can just name it sum also. I'm just having a clarity, following this same thing there. And final thing, we will be removing the last digit. So it's going to be n equal to n double slash 10. Okay. And at the end, we'll be just printing our number, not the number, I'll be printing the sum of the number. All right. So I'm saving it now and running it. So don't worry, I will also explain you with another demo. Yeah. So if you don't understand, it's not a big deal. I will explain it again. So this time I'll go with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is going to be 3, 6, 10, 15. So I'm getting 15 in the output. So I will go with some other number now. So let's imagine our number n is going to be, or number n is going to be let me go with 234. All right. So during the first iteration, okay, this is the first iteration. My number n is 234. It comes here, and remainder value is going to be rem equal to 234 modulus of 10. This will give me the remainder as 4, and it comes here, sum equal to sum variable initial value is 0, so it's going to be 0 plus 4. That will give me 4 in the variables, so 4 will be stored in sum. And here, as I told you, we will be removing the last digit from the number. So n equal to 234/10. This will give n as 23 because quotient is 23. And as I told you, we will be getting a whole number. So at the first iteration of the while loop, our number, which was 234 earlier, has now become 23. So it again comes to this line, but in this, our number is 23. All right. So it comes here. This time our number is 23. So it's going to be 23 mod 10. Modulus gives the remainder. So 20 is divisible. So it will give 3. And here's the important part. Okay. Sum equal to sum variable plus rem. Our sum variable previously had the value of 4, correct? So this time it's going to be sum equal to sum variable. It has already 4 in it. So it's going to be 4 plus rem. Our rem variable value is 3. So it's going to be 7. All right. And our number n is not 234. It is 23. Yeah, 23. So 23/10 will give us 2. That is the quotient. So this is done. Second iteration is done. And our number n is 2 now. So it comes here 2 mod 10. 2 mod 10 is not 0. It is actually 2. And it again comes here sum equal to our sum variable. Value is 7. Okay. So it's going to be 7 plus remainder. Remainder value is 2 from the previous step. This will give us 9. And it comes here. Our number is 2, not 23. 2/10 is actually 0. All right. You need to be careful here. 2 mod 10 is 2 and 2/10 is 0. That is the quotient is 0. So after this, our number, which was 2, is now, wait, I'll come to the corner, is now 0. Okay. So we'll just go here. It becomes 0. And our while loop condition is n greater than 0, but our n is equal to 0. So this while loop condition becomes false and the while loop terminates. And after this, our sum variable value is getting printed. Our sum variable has the value as 7 plus 2, which is 9, and we will be getting 9 in the output. This is basically how you find the sum of digits of a number. So if you want, I will just do the exact same number, 2, 3, 4, like 2, 3, 4. I'm getting 2 plus 3 plus 4, which is 9. So yeah, this is how you do it, guys. Such a simple program. And if you want to watch more Python tutorials, you can check the playlist of my channel. Also, I have done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, CRUD operations. Check the playlist and also my other videos. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.